everyone. So I'm doing a tarot reading today on are you heading in the right direction? Pretty simple. What I'm going to do is split the deck into three piles and stick an assorted flower on each. You can then just come through and I want you to just pick a pile that aligns up with you. Just go the first one that stands out for you. You don't need to pause it and take ages picking one. Just literally pick the one that you're drawn to. And we are just going to see if... Sorry, dropping cards. We are just going to see if the direction you're heading in is the right direction, whether you should continue on that path or that trajectory. Okay. Red, where the pile for white flowers and the pile for yellow flowers. So I want you all to just take a second now and pick a pile that works for you, and I'll do a reading on each one. I'm going to start with the red flower to begin with. Okay, so we've got the Page of Wands. We've got the Ace of Pentacles, and we've got the Queen of Wands. Okay, so right now, for everyone who, right now for everyone who chose the red flower, you've got the Page of Wands, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Queen of Wands. Now, what it's telling me right now is that you are currently in a position where maybe you've been jumping from a few projects, or you're actually juggling a whole bunch of projects all at once. It tells me that what you want to do is kind of try to focus on one, because sometimes you conduct things too many times too quickly, and that will then lead to you having not really doing them all as well as you could be. At the same time, it's a great card though for your endeavours that you're going after. You know, the light shining through and promises you success. But like I said, you will have to work on it and really focus on keeping your attention on what you're doing and trying not to lose distraction and move on to too many things at once. The Ace of Pentacles is a great card. I mean, there's nothing really to complain about with aces. So really, it shows that in your home life and all that, there's going to be a new beginning. It's kind of like a get out of debt kind of card. Think of it like that. If you've been going through a hard time with finances, with stability, with security, all that's coming to an end, and now is a good time. That's going to be a good time coming for you really soon. Okay, the Queen of Wands. This is also a very successful card. I'm assuming we're carrying on from your Page of Wands. So it looks like pretty much whatever creative endeavours you're going after right now, you are on the right direction. You're definitely going where you should be, and it's going to finish you with the Queen of Wands, which is success. As you can see, you're standing above the two lions' heads. So whatever you guys are doing right now with your creativity, with your work, with your career, stick to it, because you're definitely going where you should be and you do have success at the end of it, alright? So now just going to move on to the little bundle of white flowers, okay? And we're going to see what's going on for you guys. Okay, so we've got the Hierophant, we've got the Three of Pentacles, and we've got the Seven of Swords. So the Hierophant is, think of it kind of like that wise guru, or that person's that got a whole lot of spiritual knowledge. If you're open to it, right now that person could be coming into your life, and if you're open to it, they'll open up doors to you to a whole new path spiritually. You've just got to decide whether that's where you want to go. Also, it points to whatever, with the direction you're going in right now, the only thing that's going to just be wary not to get stuck listening to that dogmatic voice that tells you in your head what you can and can't do. Pretty much what you want to do is just go for it. If something in your head says you can't do it, well, why not? Why can't I do it? At the end of the day, this card really is a huge one for spirituality and for favors, any learning you're doing there. If you want to go tap into some psychic development, some spiritual development, anything like that, now's the time to do it. And the direction you're going in, that will definitely help you. The Three of Pentacles says that you do have a time coming where you're going to get success for your efforts. The things that you're doing now, you will start to see fruit from those things, but it's not going to be easy and just given to you. You're going to have to work for it. You're going to have to put the hard yards in and do the job. But while you are doing it, the Seven of Swords is warning you of deception. Be wary. Be wary of people trying to deceive you, trying to manipulate you, whether that's emotionally, financially, just be on guard. The direction you're going in, just because there could be deception there, doesn't mean the direction's wrong, but it means that you do need to just keep an eye out. You know, at the end of the day, you will have success and it will come to you and you will start to see a return for your efforts. But you do need to just keep an eye out for that deceptive person. Don't give in to bullies. Don't give in to anyone manipulating you, anyone pressuring you for your finances. Okay? And finally, we are going to move on to the yellow flower. Okay? So what's going on for you guys today? What direction is the direction you're heading in? Right, so I've got the Two of Pentacles, the King of Wands, and the Nine of Pentacles. Now, is the direction you're heading in the right one? Yes, it is. The Two of Pentacles is telling you that right now you are capable of doing more than two things at once. You are doing two things at once, whether that be a hobby and a new business idea, whether that be a new business and trying to manage your home, whether that be a hobby, whatever it is, you can do two things at once. You can juggle two aspects or two people or two aspects of your life. But right now it's hinting that maybe one aspect or one of those things that you're doing is taking priority more to the other one right now. So the downfall of that, though, is you'll find that you won't actually be doing either one well. You will be suffering them both because you can't find that right balance. So with the direction you're going in, you can do two things or you can be open to those two aspects of your life. Just make sure that you find the balance. If you find the balance, you will have success. Okay, you've got two very successful cards. You've got the King of Wands, who again, he sits atop the lion and he enjoys his success. If it's a person in your life, it's someone who's already got in there, but we're not talking about someone else, we're talking about you, and we're talking about the direction that you're heading in. So this, what you're doing right now, this will take you there, and you can balance those two things out, and you will find success. The Nine of Pentacles, again, is it's like the ultimate in independence. It's all about you. You can get what you want, you can get yourself to exactly where you want. It guarantees you will have security and stability in your home, all that sort of stuff, and that you can do it all off your own endeavours. It's all about you, the individual here, and the main thing you've got to do is just believe in yourself, alright? It's solely about you, which is going to get you to where you want to go, and the direction you're heading in is a great direction, because you will get there. Okay, so thanks for today, guys, and I'm going to start putting out some more readings. I'd love your feedback. Thanks. See you later.